So everyone, welcome to the Street Fighter V Finals of Button Check 2016. Well, it's basically final phase, man.
Final phase, yes, okay.
Like top 6, okay. Basically, anyone who got this far can get to the finals. So we're looking at all the potential Tigers who are gonna get
logic,
it.
By this logic, everyone who enters the tournament may make
No, that's oversimplifying it, man. Okay. Take care, man.
Bye, man. Thank you for coming. Thanks to the guy, I was just streaming.
Oh. Now, streaming is hard work, man. Yeah, all the hardware.
It was the best tournament I was ever in. Yeah, thank you a lot. Just come next time again.
Oh, yeah. Oh, we don't have a save game, so we're gonna have to skip the story bit.
But. Yeah, it's because we are not online, right?
Probably yes.
Because yesterday it was normally running without these issues.
Oh, I see, I see.
What are they doing?
Maybe they're looking for a different account that has the safe, I don't know.
Oh, I see. That makes sense. Yes.
Okay. So can you switch to chat for a bit? So let's see what the monsters are saying.
Where's Ryu? He's here.
Well, I'm here, my man. I'm here. I mean, it's the Street Fighter V top 6. Where else would I be?
Hey, come on. Everyone needs break. Except the stream.
Yeah. No, but it's all good. I mean, I'm very hyped, especially I've already talked about it a bit when Mortal Kombat X was ending, but the national variety is very interesting right now. We have people from all over Europe and Kuwait.
And US.
Well, yes, yes. So EU champ is still in the bracket.
I see. So let me check.
I don't know the top 6, so...
Oh, he's not. Here. I'm sorry.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
Okay, okay. But we still have Hayat, we have Winces, we have Kejim representing Poland, of course, and Kendeep. So...
We don't have anyone from Czech Republic.
Oh, too bad. I was expecting PRK to still be in the bracket.
Well, he's not... playing SF5 much, he don't like the game.
Oh, I see.
He played it, but he's not enjoying it. It's not Guilty Gear.
Well,
it's very simple. Like, is the game Guilty Gear? Yes, it's fun. No, it's not fun.
Well, I understand that. I understand that. Man, I spent 3 months trying to play Street Fighter V, and then I spent 4 hours playing Guilty Gear, and I can't get away.
I will be right back. I need to tune down the sound on the stage. Please, Stream Monsters, can you confirm how our voice is compared to the sound of the game?
Oh, yes, please. Give us some feedback. Now we're just starting with Karin and Ken. It's like you've seen before, it's Chino versus Semper Pops. And now we can go back to the match.
Round one.
So.
Fight.
Oh, they're doing the battle check, that's fine. Now, in this matchup, I guess we have two characters that are kind of similar with their ways of getting in. Now, Ken has better ways of aerial offense with his Tatsumakis that basically function like dive kick, whereas Karin has better options off of her command dash. And of course, a very strong crouching medium kick and standing medium punch. But so the players mixed me up a bit. Okay, now that is gonna be a much different matchup than what I was expecting. So we have.
I believe this will be a lot about how strong the basics are.
The basics, you say. See, with Nash, it's kind of a different story because yes, you can rely on footsies and fundamentals, but you can also burn a lot of meter, get plus on block, and just go ham. At least until your opponent adapts to it.
Yes, exactly. But with Kami, it's like sheer once you hit the ground. Once you hit the ground, you really need to see that. And you will get on the ground at least once.
Yes.
Unless you are like, really much better than you are really, really lucky.
And now Semper Pops starts with some strong offense, gets a lot of hits. But just like that, Chino is able to revert. And we have Crash Counter combo. This is going to be it for the first round of the top 6 of Button Check 2016 Street Fighter V tournament. Oh, we're having a bit of issues. Okay, the players have decided to go at it.
It's not on the player,
okay. I see.
It's pretty possible. No one ever was willing to be big enough someone, and now it's my round.
Yeah, I guess that
so
makes sense.
But if it's not impact the game at all, the organizer may decide to separate. I believe it's very good.
Okay, that's nice. And the second round goes for Semper Pops. Very strong offense, he lost only just a sliver of his health. So, goes for the neutral jump, waiting for Chino to move forward with some of his specials.
Like, this is the problem with Sonic. As an Ash, you cannot rely on your Sonic move.
Yes.
She has so many ways how to get around them directly to you, and you
can
do that. And you need the neutral.
She can just use the drills basically on reaction.
Yes.
Oh, and he gets the stun. Now this is a very dominant play. Oh, he reads the mashing. That's interesting. That's very interesting for Semper Pops.
But don't forget, this is first to three.
Okay.
We are in the top 8 already.
Thanks.
So there's enough time to adapt.
Yep.
And realize what your round one or what your opponent
fights.
Yes, thanks for reminding all of us. Oh, and Chino goes for the side, but doesn't get the hit. Semper Pops did manage to recover on time, goes for the throw. And now what's going next? He tried to stand in Grandhouse, but was not in range. Oh, very nice anti-airs with the light punch and gets the stun.
Yeah, the character is fast for that. They hit the area with the light punch and then decide to cross under you.
Yes, that's right. The same.
Good we just saw.
Yeah, the same goes for Chun-Li, for example.
Yeah.
Oh, Chino tried to go for the bazooka knee, but doesn't get the hit.
And
another cross under. Now Semper Pops is dominating this match, really, with all the footsies on point. Very nice base with the standing punches.
And stun again.
Yep.
Third stun in last 4 rounds.
Yes, that's it.
That's quite something.
He gets the knee, but unfortunately he was so close that he was not advantageous on hit. Or at least not as much as he thought he would be. So, it's time to adapt or die.
It's time to change something in your game because obviously,
round one.
If you're Chinook,
fight.
Now, with Chinook, it's hard for me to pinpoint what exactly is the thing he should change because Semper Pops is just dominating the game for now. Okay, tries to go for anti-air but trades.
Maybe just try to calm down, slow down the game and try to gain his attention to get in.
Yeah, that's the thing. Oh, we have a little bit of stare down. Is that the thing? Because Street Fighter V is generally a bit slower. Oh, very nice. I mean, he didn't get the combo, but he did get advantage on block after the EX moonsault. Oh, but here comes Semper Pops with the block strings and again the EX dive kick. That is something Chino cannot defend against. But here, he does a very nice jump back fierce. Very strong, good damage. And here comes Semper Pops with the activated V-trigger, gets the drill but does not have enough meter for the follow-up. So whoever gets the next hit may just take it. With Chino, I'm betting that he's thinking about going EX, but he makes the mistake of going Bazooka. Bazooka on block is usually punishable, but from max range it's simply disadvantages. So Semper Pops goes for the throw and steals the round, just like that. So we have a jump in fierce. Chino went for the shimmy but did not press the button again, so Semper Pops went for the shimmy but did not press the button again, and so he gets another throw. And again he goes for the standing roundhouse but is again out of range. Now I'm betting that this would beat a few wake up options, but it's not really an advantageous option, especially if you have already established a strong wake up pressure. Like now Semper Pops got Chino a bit afraid to press buttons. Oh, but he confirms into the super and this is gonna be it. Now see, with Nash.
So Semper Pops is moving to winners finals?
Yes. And Okay. Okay, we're having a little bit of mix up
there
here.
There's an issue that some...
What happened?
So what? So nearly... We had swap names. So it was... We had swap names. So it was Chino on the...
Oh!
I was asking, and I was told that it's Ember Pups on Kamen.
Okay, well, that that was a bit of a mix-up.
I'm really sorry.
So we have Chino.
And that means that the Ember Pups... I'm really sorry, streamers. Like, there are so many players I'm not as familiar with. Yeah. Okay, so that means that Chino is moving to losers. So and because he's in a rush because of his transport back to Italy,
okay.
We will follow him directly to the losers.
I see.
Find where it is.
So he should be against Ken Deep right now, if I recall well.
No, against
no.
Kejim.
Kejim, okay. So we have Semper Pops against Kejim.
Yes. And we know now that Ember Pups is nice.
Yes.
I'm sorry, like, this is the problem. You are dependent on other people.
Oh, and lower the volume of the game a bit. We've been having some reports from the monsters.
Okay. So, I lowered the game. Please confirm if it's okay or not. And once again, I'm really, really sorry.
Okay.
So, it's
so now we're adjusting the names a bit. We have Kejim on one side, Semper Pups on the other, and this is losers. So whoever loses
just
that.
Let me check.
Yeah.
This is losers top six.
Yeah. So whoever loses that goes home.
Yes.
And
this is exactly what Semper Pups needs now.
Yes.
So he's in.
That's right.
He's quite biased in this match.
Right. So now he's discouraged from winning. But let's see what he's gonna do with this. That's a bit of a tough game to play, you know, all the nerves with your transportation coming soon. Now with Kejim we already saw yesterday that he's gonna sport some Mika. And of course
everyone hates him. I don't know why, like Mika is so good character. It's not a Street Fighter character. I think that's the issue.
Well,
but she's so fun to watch, she's so fun to play with, and like if you understand the mindset, she's fun to play against.
Well, to a point I'll agree, but you know, she is a Street Fighter character, she's just not much of a Street Fighter 5 character. Because she does go against most of what the other characters do according to their game plan. General, at least. So we have this El Fuerte look-alike, and here
round
we go with Semper Pops, Nash, and Kejim's Armika. Okay, so opener, two sides, very simple, a basic opener from Nash players, but it usually works.
Yeah, and that's why so many players starting to hold the round versus Nash with jump.
Yes, yes, because that would beat
the. You open with the big combo there.
Yeah, that's right.
But for Nash, basically this means he needs to completely reverse the plan from
the
game.
And so
Mika needs to hit her away, and it's possible.
Yeah. And so, just like that, Kejim went for the frame grab, then for the command grab, and then for Nadeshka mix-ups. And we have a stun and a killing combo.
I must say that all the players that are now playing against Semper Pups have some slides.
They indeed do. Now, Kejim, of course, the least of the crowd favorites due to him playing Mika. But it's also very nice to see some FGC heels showing up around here.
And the funny thing is, every time the crowd starts booing on him or cheering his opponent, he just laughs.
Yeah.
And he seems really happy, like.
Yeah, because, you know, it's not even some malicious intent of getting people angry. He's just happy that he can get so many emotions from other people.
I can imagine.
Oh, and we get a crash counter. This is gonna be big. Dope. He drops the combo but goes for the mix-up. And another moonsault, but this time catching Stavsky with jumping roundhouse. Okay, and EX side.
That's this is the way how to stop Mega Man.
Yeah.
You have enough bars. Because the jump-ins are really tricky.
Fire. Yeah.
Bring so many angles, so many options.
Yeah, but basically.
Stops all of them.
Yeah, but basically against Mika you should keep her away on the ground, force her to jump and then anti-air. That's the best way to play against Mika, but of course good Mika will make it very tough for you. Just like that, once he gets in, catching, gets the stun, goes for the follow-up. This is gonna be big, and he's working on a perfect, and he went for it, but dropped it. Okay, now Semper Pops was ready with the jump out. Oh yes. Although, you know,
if it works, it's awesome.
Yeah, if it works, it's amazing play. If it's not, well, you're getting cocky and getting punished for it. Okay, and another jump in now. See, that's the thing. Semper Pops blocks the jump ins very well, but he does not counter them, and that's what he should be doing. That's what he should focus on.
If Mika hits her jump in, it's bonus.
Yeah.
Because if you block the jump in, she's at plus and she's in your face, and
yes,
that's what she needs.
Round yes, exactly. One.
Like the hit out of the jump in itself is just a bonus.
Yes, yes. Okay, tries to go for the body splash. Oh, and the jumping roundhouse. And
already you see slowly but surely pushing him to the floor.
And now catching half the corner. Trying to close the distance a little bit.
Yeah, and the problem with Mika is, with another flap, you can choose if he's going forward or backwards.
Yes.
So being close to the corner against Mika is the same as being in the corner.
Yes. Yes. And now again, catching goes for the grab and sets up the command throw. And a one hit takes it.
And
goes for EX Peach. That's very good. Has armor. Deals just a little bit
and
of cheat.
Round two.
Yes, he's very proud of himself. Why wouldn't you? You're catching.
You're a Mika player.
No, he's proud because he's catching. Okay, so. Now look at what's happening here. Semper Pops does not create distance by using his normals or specials. He tries to jump away, he tries to backdash, and that's not really what he should be doing against Mika.
He's trying to anticipate what he's
doing. Oh, and just like that, catching dashes in with the command grab.
And in the corner.
Yes, and that's an EX, so it's additional damage.
Throw, then another throw.
And that's gonna be it.
And it's 2-0.
Yes. And that is very unfortunate for Semper Pops. Just like that, he's losing another match, straight losses.
I must say, this is something as a player I insanely hate. You make it to, I don't know, top 8 or something.
Yeah.
And you went to the stream. First time after 10 matches, you won convincingly. You
yes.
go to the stream and you lose 2 times convincingly. Yes. And everyone thinks that you're like, you don't know how to play. So come on!
Yeah, but you know, that's people mentality. You just have to rise above it. Oh, see, that's good. He should be going for the normals. He should be creating space with the offense he's performing. But unfortunately, Ketchum is in there. He's a very experienced player, and he likes Street Fighter V. He's been playing since the beta. Okay, goes for the Nadeshko. No, not all the times. He's been sticking to Bison, but he switched to Mika. Not too long ago, I guess, about a month or so. And again... Yes, and again with the throw.
If I would follow my gross logic, I would say he's dumb. Because that's the logic of the Protol.
Oh yeah, yeah. And in the meantime, see, that Semper Pops backing away, going towards the corner. This is very risky for him, and he gets the overhead block. Ketchum dashes in with the regular grab. Now that is interesting for Ketchum because as you can see, he's doing a lot of regular throws, but since they are faster, I mean, on the recovery, he would not be punished if Semper Pops just jumped away.
And what's more, if you use this throw as a meaty and you're going up, last time to hit him with anti-air.
That's true.
Not only that he will not punish you throwing, but you will punish him for throwing.
Yes.
That means that you will push your opponent to jump back.
Yes.
And that will make your command throw safe.
Yes, that's right. And on top of that, that would make your opponent move away and towards the corner, of course. So we're having another EX throw. Kenjin is doing them all the time right now. And just the tiniest bit of damage is gonna seal the deal for Kenjin. Semperpup still trying, going on a bit of the offense. Oh, but he's trying so hard with the jump-ins. Now Kenjin did not anti-air.
Now he plays like I expected him to play all the time.
Yeah. Okay, he's gonna get hit by the Nadeshiko. No, Kenjin holds it. And Semperpups goes for the super and he will be punished. That is it for Semperpups. He's going home.
Yeah, but it was hard to read.
Yeah, and it's...
It was like... I will try.
Yeah. That was a Hail Mary. But you see, it's the worst thing when you're actually starting to get some offense going. You're starting to understand the matchup. But it's just too late. It's just too late. And that it was for Semperpups. Kenjin advances.
We are going back to standard schedule, so we will finish the winners now.
Okay.
And after that we will follow up with losers. So that means that now Hayat versus Wincest.
Yes.
Is coming.
And let's not forget, Wincest is also one of the old timers from Virtual Dojo Vienna. That is the VDV Wincest. And by all means, he's a dedicated player. I talked to him yesterday. He said that he's taking Street Fighter V very seriously. I remember him playing Street Fighter 3. I remember him playing Street Fighter 4. Very strong Akuma player. He really has the Vortex game down. So we can expect a lot of interesting gameplay moves, I would say, like sequences maybe. Because.
And do you know who he's playing?
Oh yes, he's playing against Hayat.
No, who? I mean character.
Oh, the character. I don't know who he plays in Street Fighter V. I would assume either maybe Ryu or Chun-Li. But he may surprise us here. I'm not sure.
I would rather go to ask to not make the mistake again.
Oh no, that's okay, because I know that Hayat is going to be playing Chun-Li.
Okay.
So it's fine.
That makes
He's not going to be switching characters right now, you know, in the middle of top 6. Okay. And we're going for Chun-Li and... Oh, is Wincest? No. Oh, Wincest is going for the third top tier. Yes, with Nash.
Chun-Li.
Okay, now, Hayat has a lot of experience playing against Nash. What I'm anxious to see is whether or not Wincest is gonna play similarly to the Nashes that Hayat was playing against.
There's a lot of options how to play.
Round one.
Yeah, he's a very versatile character.
Exactly.
Okay, and now Hayat going in and then creating a bit of distance. Wincest absorbing the fireballs with the V-skill.
This breakout is far quite slow.
Oh yes. And now the standing fierce, very strong in this game, from Chun-Li. Now what's important about standing fierce, it's not part of the game yet, but Hayat is very on point with cancels into super. So if he has 3 bars, that's very big.
Okay,
Wincest tries to escape with the V-trigger, but Hayat anticipates and goes for the offense. Okay, strong. Now Wincest finally has a bit of space to work with, gets the crush counter sweep. Oh, but the entire game from Hayat, you should really expect him to perform in this.
Hey, come on, anti-airing with Chun-Li is the easiest way. From all the anti-airs. Like, it's not the strongest anti-air or something, it's just the easiest to use.
Well, yes. Her standing short is very strong. But as we can see, she has other anti-airs to use that are also rather good. And now we have the instant legs. Wincest going for the second Sonic Boom. And feeling the space a little bit. Trying to incite Wincest to get in. And right now Hayat is just thinking, okay, I'm going in. Alright. I got it. He's not gonna escape this corner. Yes,
and the Chun-Li can do.
Yeah, and now Hayat is just thinking, okay, whenever he gets in, I'm gonna super, I'm gonna kill him. Oh, I don't have to. I'm high up.
Chun-Li wins.
Okay, so the first match went to Hayat. I would say pretty convincingly, but Wincest still has time to adapt.
Round one.
Because the thing is, Hyatt is very strong, but right now he's playing his regular game. What Winston has to do is to recognize the patterns that Hyatt is using and force him to change them. Okay, gets the crash counter sweep with the Chun-Li shenanigans of the stomps. Okay, another fierce. This is big damage from a single hit. Oh!
It looks like Winston is struggling to find a way how to get into the Chun-Li's offense.
Yes. And now crash counter sweep, goes for throw, gets it. Another sweep, regular, goes for the combo. Okay, and Hyatt almost stunned, but saves himself with the V-reversal. Now that is something Winston might start thinking about, is doing V-reversals, because he's hogging all the meter, and I understand that with Nash, your V-trigger is very strong and it charges up very quickly. But sometimes you just have to burn it, sometimes you just have to escape.
Yeah, the thing is that in the result, if you need a repetition in the corner, V-reversal works the same way as
yes.
You yes. Just get out of the corner.
Yes, but it's cheaper.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, and another...
V-trigger,
yeah.
V-trigger, you can use it both defensively and...
Yes. Oh, gets the hit with the follow-up lightning leg. Again, thanks to throw. But Winston was ready with the V-trigger and a short follow-up.
Nice.
Okay, lands the overhead.
Let's see if it was just a lucky round, let's say, or if he really finds a way.
Oh, no. Winston is the real deal. You'll see. Okay, sweep for sweep.
Yes.
Sweep again, and another sweep. How many sweeps are we going in? Okay, goes under Chun-Li, but unfortunately he has too much recovery to block in time. Gets thrown and escapes, but gets hit with the entire standing jab. And Hyatt with the offense, relentless pressure, gets the trade and the stun. Now that is it. He confirms into super. So that's 2-0 for Hyatt.
Like, I don't think about Winston's skill. It was like he's obviously struggling to find a way how to stop Chun-Li's offense.
See,
he, in that round, he stopped it once
and
didn't stop after it himself.
Yes.
So that was what I meant. If he really found a way how to stop it, or if it was like, I stop it and follow from there successfully till the very end.
Fight!
Because, you know, the struggle right here is that Chun-Li's buttons are very strong, so it's hard for Nash to counter it with normals of his own.
And you see, if you don't know how to counter it, doesn't matter like that.
Yes. Because the thing is that Winston all gets the crash counter but doesn't get the follow-up. This is very bad for Winston, but Hyatt is still stunned. Very nice. And now, see, the thing is that once Nash gets going, he can still maintain a very strong pressure game. And that's what Winston knows. What he doesn't know is how to get inside Hyatt's head. Oh, gets the crash counter but doesn't get the follow-up, but the throw gets it. Because the most important thing for Winston right now, from these few matches, is to start countering the instant air legs. Because that does stop Chun-Li in her tracks. Okay, mid game.
Right now, for Hyatt, it is if I don't know what to do, I do instant air legs.
Yeah, I'm just having the go-to sequence that I end with lightning legs. And as soon as he doesn't punish me, I can do it again.
Yes, and
as long. Yes, of course. That's why it's very strong. Okay. Bates Winces to absorb the projectile, but ultimately it's Winces who gets the advantage. Unfortunately, he dashes in right into standing roundhouse. Another very strong normal from Chun-Li, and we get confirm after V-trigger, but Winces must be careful because he's almost within cheap range. Hyatt still has super available. Winces does not have the reversal right now, but gets the jump in. This is big. Oh, but Hyatt confirms and doesn't cheat. Oh, but
that was unlucky.
See, that's terrible. Because ultimately, EX lightning legs are minus 2 on block, but sometimes you just stagger your response and you don't get it in time. Okay, now.
Because the air legs end earlier in the game than on the screen.
Yeah, yeah.
Still moving your legs, but you are already pretty moved.
Yes, that's right. And just like that, we have one good response. Oh, very nice. V-reversals out of the corner. This is important for him. Okay, thanks to Troll. Now, Air Lightning Legs, exactly. Goes for the moonsault, but Hayat is ready with the air-to-air. Confirms, knocks down, and is ready for the V-reverse, for the V-trigger.
And that's it.
That's it now. Winces is going back to loser's bracket. He can chill there for a second before his next match. Now, I guess the most important thing for Winces, if he is to play Hayat again in the winner in the grand finals, he may still get there, is to learn to reliably counter Lightning Legs.
He have time. He have time to think about what happened, what he can do better,
because
or what he can change.
I'm not sure about Nash, but many characters can just jab Lightning Legs and it works. With Nash, I guess maybe well-placed crouching strong could beat the Lightning Legs with a little bit of the additional damage.
Most characters can beat it with the crouching jab.
Yes, that's right. Or standing.
It's strong, but it's stopping it.
Yes, and that's what's important.
Then there are characters that can use big moves because of some special hurtbox properties.
Yep.
Like Zangief, he can use Lariat.
Oh, yes.
Because it, for some unknown reason, it's in the hurtboxes and hitboxes.
Yeah.
Avoids the hitbox of first two.
Okay.
So we have enough time to start the move and to shut Chun-Li down from the air.
Yes, that's right. And see, many characters can just Shoryuken through it, although that's a bit risky. But see, the thing was that Hayat got comfortable. He used Lightning Legs in the same situations all the time. And Winces just didn't get the counters going on. Now, who is going to play? Yes, we have Chino and Hayat. So, again, we have Chino, the the Kami player, whom we got called.
Once again, I'm sorry.
Yeah, we called him a little bit wrong, but now we got it right. And Hayat, the well-known player who's from Kuwait, but for the most part he stays in Poland. And there he used to dominate all sorts of games. He was unbeatable in Street Fighter 4. Now he's unbeatable in Street Fighter 5. And in the meantime,
maybe he will be beatable. So far, none such competitor ever.
Yeah.
Stand again.
In the meantime, Hayat was unbeatable in Marvel vs. Capcom 3. One of the games he took seriously.
That no one is playing it. It is still on Evo.
Oh yeah, but they used to play it. They used to play it even in Poland, you know.
Like Marvel is such. Game.
Yes.
Like, I'm afraid it will stay on Evo for 3, maybe 5 more years unless there will be another game of similar kind.
You know what?
People love to watch it.
Yes, I wouldn't say use the word fear, because the thing is that Marvel is cool to watch.
Yes, exactly.
Even with the same teams over and over again, it sometimes gets a bit tiring, I must admit. I haven't watched full Top 8 in the longest time. But ultimately, it's always hype at some point.
I agree, definitely.
Yeah, and now we have.
When is like Street Fighter 5 came out?
Yep.
Street Fighter 4 is out of the Evo. People are complaining or where?
Yes.
I didn't hear much complaints lately. They are playing.
Oh, they're going in.
Directly, it's okay. So.
Okay. So Chino has switched to Ken. I would say that it might be a better matchup against Chun-Li, but it's very hard to say yet. Now, Ken is of course rather mobile character, not the most, but pretty much, yeah.
But Enu is great, then.
Yeah.
If you find some openings, you win or not.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so he scores a knockdown off of the V-triggered fireball. But gets anti-aired by Hayat. He's always on point with the shorts.
And you see, the first instant air lag when you will say Shoryuken.
Yes, that's how you have to play this matchup, because that nets you the most damage.
Round 2. Fight.
And it's easy to buffer too, that's important. So Hayat is sitting on full meter, Chino is rather reliant on burning meter when necessary.
Like, this is something I already realized, like, Hayat not use meter, except for the hard, at all, only for the wake-up revival.
Yes. But see, that's the main use, fortunately, is using it for Wake Up Reversal. And Hayat will go for the super, but only if either he feels comfortable or if it heals. Yeah, the, well, that's the same, basically. Okay, now we have the side switch and confirmed. That's gonna be match round, match win for Hayat. So 1-0, Hayat against Chinu. Very nice, 42 hit combo, very skillful, my friends. Right now we're having players who never drop their combos and have a lot of tricks up their sleeves. Now we haven't seen too many shenanigans from Hayat yet with the stomps and side switches.
Fight. Yeah, but in...
Oh, we have...
Oh, okay, character change.
Okay, okay.
Like he plays very conservative Chun-Li,
yes,
but
yes.
On the other hand, he don't need to use the shenanigans yet. At
yes.
On the stream.
Yes, see, that's the thing. He is constantly in his zone. He's very comfortable with how he plays. And he... And the thing with Hayat is that he got the skill of thinking about the game mid-match. So when he makes the decision that he doesn't have to mix anything up, he doesn't have to change the playstyle, he won't. Of course, when he starts being challenged with some of his tricks, he will switch it up and he will mix it up. But for now, he doesn't have to. That's what he decides, I guess. Okay.
Most of them are 1 or 2.
Yeah.
Against the computer, I mean.
Yep.
And a lot of them involves a lot of risk.
Yeah.
Why to take risk? And why to show your cards you have in your sleeve?
Yep.
If you don't need to.
Yep. But he just may have to, because Chinu just ran a drain on him in the first round. Oh, gets the hit, does not get the reset. And however, Chinu is very good at staying in Hayat's face. Later he showed very nice shimmy, very nice deck throw baits. Oh, and neutral jump gets shorted for it. Kikoken starts the offense and baits Chinu into doing the V-skill. Very predictably. So the characters are staying mid-range. Now Hayat may be fishing for the super, but he's still a little bit far away from killing range. Okay, going for the medium kick. He tries to slowly ease in. Oh, but here comes Chinu with a big combo into the super that is going to whip!
Wow.
And just like that, Chinu lost his meter, he lost his trigger,
but he wins the match.
Yeah, he still managed to win it. So that's 1 point all. Now we have a match going, just like that. The first match was very much in Hayat's favor, but after switching characters, Chinu is the one running the train. Okay, standing fierce. That's just a tiny bit of great damage, but it adds up. Oh, and just like that, he lost much more health than he should from the first hit. Okay, we have side switch and the instant air legs, but a bit too far for the conversion. Okay, goes for the Kikoken. Now, here we have punish coming. But I'm wondering if Chinu couldn't Shoryuken through the Kikoken. I guess he's afraid, and he should be. After all, DPs here are very much more punishable than in other games. Yes, of course. Well, yeah. And the first round again for Chinu. He managed to get a stun off of Hayat. This is not something you see every day, my friends. Okay, goes for the Kikoken, goes for standing strong traits, and eats the DP. Now, crouching forward into drill, that's classic tactics from Kami. Oh, but standing strong, now he's putting the wall of China in front of him, so hard for Chinu to beat this. Oh, goes for the throw, but not quite in range. This is very bad for Hayat. He's losing so much from his offense now. Chinu's stun is all down, and he activates the super. This is going to hit. Yeah, but it will not kill, and Hayat has full meter, full V trigger, and he hit. Oh, so close! Burns meter for the EX and baits him. That's gonna be it if he pulls it off. Yes.
And what's important is
final round.
Yes. That's right. Fight. And this is where this meter will count, because Chinu does not have meter. He probably will build a full super bar, but we're not gonna see it for a while now. And all this time, Hayat is ready.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, now Chinu sitting on almost full V-trigger. Yes. Now his V-trigger is ready. Hayat burns meter for EX reversal, gets Chinu off of him, but continues the pressure nonetheless. Goes forward, tries to kill him with the standing for the spear, and the crouching jab gets it. Now I wonder if we're gonna see crouching jab winning EVO, but for now we have crouching jab winning a match at Button Check. This is very big. We have winners finals already.
Fight.
So. Oh, eats the DP, gets the sweep, and starts his offense with the kickoff, and then the sweep, then eats the DP again. Crouching jab, crouching medium. Again, with the kickoff, and he's ready for the drill, punishes. Okay, punish into spinning bird kick, but gets hit with the throw. Oh, and he's ready with the jump roundhouse. Oh, and that beats any jump, and it's very hard. So again, standing fierce, such a strong move. Now Hyatt's footsies are on point, but he gets hit by just the tip of drill and wakes up jab.
Like Hyatt changing his style after the first game against Kemi. His style is playing now defensively. And it works, it paid out.
Yes.
Last game and it paid out.
Oh, but gets hit by jumping roundhouse. Now Chinu is in there, but gets pushed away just a bit, but gets the hit with the standing fierce into the drill. Oh, Hayat is ready with the crouching forwards. Oh, does not expect the side switch, but gets Chinu off of him with the EX reversal. Now Hayat's stun is almost all down. Okay, but Chinu activates the V-trigger, goes to punish the fireball.
Saves the meter.
Yes. Okay, so we have... Yes. Okay, now Hayat backing out. Backing off. Oh, and he goes in just like that for the SPK knockdown. Gets hit by V-skill, but he trades, so Chinu cannot follow up. But he reads the DX reversal. Oh, and such a nice bait. Oh, the shimmy is real here, and we get a full punish. But it's still not gonna kill, and Hayat has full meter. What's he gonna do? Is he gonna wake up with the EX? No, he's saving the meter. Oh, gets the crush counter.
Don't forget Hayat.
Yes. Oh, and Chinu was ready for it. Now Hayat is getting a little bit predictable with his Kikokens. Let's see if he can mix it up. See, the thing is, Hayat does not really have to be aware of the Kikoken game for the most part of the match, but as soon as Chinu gets his V-trigger, Hayat has to change it. Oh, eats the DP very quickly. Chinu goes for the dive kick, but lacks range and gets hit for it. Now another sweep from Hayat. Trying to bait the DP, but it didn't work out too well. Oh, and Chinu activates V-trigger. Gets the combo. Yes, this is solid damage around the 300. Oh, eats the EX reversal, but jumps in. Yep. So Hayat opts to burn his trigger. He gets trash count, doesn't follow up, and now second V trigger from Chinu.
And it's 2-2, so that puts
round two.
Chinu on the
winners grand finals.
His round away from grand finals.
Yeah, that is match point for Chinu. And now we have the Kikoken game. He can still do it relatively safely. Oh, and we get the lightning legs, starting the offense, goes for the throw, but Chinu is ready. Now jumps right into the EX spinning bird kick, but manages to follow it up with a little bit of offense, a little bit of knockdown, and Hayat escapes, but not quite gets hit by the DP. Okay, now Hayat, Chinu has a slight light lead, but it gets bigger right now, goes for the reset side switch. Oh, and gets the throw, this is big, one hit, and Hayat is either dead or stunned. all but it's Hayat who reverses the momentum. Yeah, but see, this is big change from Hayat because now he does not have meter for EX reversal on wake up. He still has V trigger, but it's slowly going down. Okay, one hit, one hit. Oh, and Chinu is ready. He's gonna fish for the drill. Oh, so close! And he didn't get it! The V trigger meter ran out just as he hit with the drill, so he couldn't follow it up.
Fight.
Okay, that is hard. Yeah, that is heartbreaking for Chinu, but I believe he still has his composure, a few upgrades here and there. Oh, this is big, big hit from Hayat at the standing roundhouse. The anti-air. Okay, but Chinu is aware as well. He gets the hit with the jumping roundhouse, then neutral jumps, the EX reversal Hayat, and again gets the hit. Okay, now he gets the throw, that is it.
Very nice, very close. But this was definitely a match that, like, on the play, this was winners finals.
Yes,
and
this
it was quite some match.
Yes, we had two winners over here. But now only one remains. And now Hayat is focused, he's still thinking about the game because he's still in the tournament, I must remind you. He got knocked down to loser's bracket, but Hayat is not one to be faced by it. Let's wait and see who is he gonna be playing against now.
Now it should be Candy versus Wincest.
Yes, correct. It's Candy versus Wincest, and the winner of that goes on to face Kejim, who in turn will play for the exclusive right to fight Hayat in Losers Finals. So we have Kejim winning, waiting in Losers Semis, Hayat waiting in Losers Finals. And right now, Candip and Wincest. Now, Candip, German player, Wincest, Austrian, VDV, out the Virtual Dojo Vienna. Both players taking Street Fighter V seriously. And I really hope we're gonna see a nice hype match over here. Okay, so now we're having a button check, it's almost done. Yes, Wincest is still in.
Someone on the chat was supposed to write adjust microphone, but I don't know, I cannot even find it.
Okay, I guess.
Is there any issue with the microphones?
Yeah, come on, monsters, please give us some feedback. I'm guessing everything is fine right now.
Yeah, I hope so.
Yeah. Okay, so. So Wincest is going with Nash, whereas Candip is going with Laura, the very infamous Bonita costume. And let's see which one will come out on top. I guess with Laura, whoever comes out on top is gonna be the crowd favorite. So, now Wincest is starting by backing himself to the corner. This is kind of weird because Laura does not have that strong of a footsie game. Of course, she has good normals, but.
But on the other hand, like, why not? Nash is strong.
Yeah, that's true. So, definitely Nash can dominate the footsie game, but he has to mix it up a lot. So as not to get predictable, he's not Chun-Li definitely, but what Nash can do is mix it up with the specials, and until he gets anti-air, is very good. But here we have Candy activating V-Trigger early. Was so close to getting the stun, but not quite. Just the tiniest hit would net him stun. And like that, Wincest reverses, gets the anti-air going, not this time though, and the medium kick gets it. Now medium kick from Nash, as usual for most characters, but not all of course, is not cancelable, but it covers a good chunk of distance in front of the character. And of course it's a low. So, Wincest gets a throw, gives us a nice showing of Laura's front. And not much after that, he decides to keep his distance. can keep going in now. The regular Laura specials. Going for a short confirm and then the elbow. Okay, now. Candy was trying to do something against the fireball, but he just walked into it. And, oh my, so far...
Vita's defense is quite strong against
Laura. So far we have sort of a pause in the game, because both players are training single hits and not really going in strong. But like, look at Winces, how he's moving, like, a bit towards, a bit back.
Yeah.
He's doing the shimmy at a very big distance away from his opponent. But if Candeep were to do something unsafe or slow, he could just sight through the move and then convert into super. So Candeep could not just press a button. And now,
round one.
Laura, of course, is considered a lower tier character than Nash, but where her potential lives is the very close mix of game and the resets, especially if she has the V trigger active. Yes.
She can dish out inside damage in normal.
Yes, yes. Laura is sort of.
Without critical arm, I mean, this is
yes.
Like, with critical arm, everyone can, but without
yes.
it, it's not that common.
Yes. She's kind of like Abel from Street Fighter 4.
Yeah.
Okay, and right now Wince has got a little bit of an early lead, but he gets hit time and time again with the single hits, and now Candeep can start his game. Oh, but Wince has gone for the V-trigger. Candeep was not ready for it, not at all. Gets hit, now both players almost equal on life. Candeep still has a slight advantage. But with Laura, you can't stay on the defense, you have to go in. This is a very offense-based character.
Yeah.
And up close. Okay, goes for the elbows. Now, elbows unblocked, this is kind of a weird situation because it is negative unblocked, not punishable, but disadvantages. And still, Candeep manages to maintain pressure after being blocked.
It depends. Some of Laura's elbows are plus. Because every punch you throw out is elbow. So you need to see which elbow
you
use.
Yeah, I guess so.
You see, this was like elbow.
Yeah, she's kind of like Dudley in that respect. So, right now, full screen, Winces is throwing a few fireballs. He's trying to bait Candeep into an unsafe jump in. Oh, decides to burn the meter. This is weird. Then he throws the fireball at the worst possible distance and Candeep capitalizes on that mistake.
Yes.
Goes in with the neutral jump, trying to bait something, but does not work out really well. And again, neutral jumps over the fireball, steady. Oh, and gets the crush counter. But saves his meter, does not go for reset. Oh, and again, the V-trigger from now, very strong if you're not ready for it. If you're ready for it, it can be easily countered. But you have to predict it, sort of.
Laura wins.
And now, Candeep is winning it's his second match, I believe?
No, it's 1-1.
It's 1-1, okay. So I got kind of caught up in the game, but
Round one.
Have one match all.
Fight!
And now, what's gonna happen? So Winces was trying to start with the side, while Candeep was trying to start with the dashing elbow, and they traded. So far no one has the advantage. Oh, Candeep was doing a very good jumping, but he just very slightly mistimed it and did not hit crouching Winces. Now he's proceeding to run a train in the corner, very strong. Laura in the corner, you do not want to get pushed back. But
yeah,
it's
the overhead.
Yeah, the Winces with the overheads going in. Oh, and now Candeep was ready with the V reversal. This is important. He gets out, but another overhead.
It was like five.
Yes.
Almost in a row.
Now see, the thing is, you can have this sort of mentality that you do not have to block overheads in Street Fighter 5 because they usually net very little damage compared to what you would be if you were hit low. But you can't get hit by five overheads in a row. This piles up. Okay, standing short. Very good at this distance.
Nice damage.
Oh, and wake up jump into the side. Oh, and teleport, this is gonna be big. Strong punish from Winces, does not convert to super. Candeep still has a lot of life left, and gets the knockdown. Oh, and just like that, he stand roundhouses.
Yeah, the wake up jet is very strong.
But you can...
If your opponent know how to counter them,
yes.
You can end up with a crush counter.
Yes, you can beat those definitely, as long as you're prepared. And so we're having regular throw. Again, Wizzes was trying to fish for the crush counter, or the meaty, should I say. And nice cross up, very strong jumping forward from Laura. Very good move, good vector. Oh, and they're trying with the dash in, dash out, but scan deep that gets the advantage. And what's it gonna be? Jump in neutral. Oh, and Winces jumps in with short combo, converts into a throw, short reset, and again jumps in, goes for the shimmy, but does not get the hit. And here comes Candy, a little bit of a stare down. Oh,
the jumping going on right now.
Yeah. And that's it. So Candy 2, Winces 1. It is best. It is first to 3, right?
Yes. One of the commentators is a little quiet.
Okay, that's weird.
I think the mic may be far from his mouth. This is the message we get.
Round one. That is interesting.
Fight.
Okay, so
tell us, is it Unicorn
or is it Hiryu who is quiet?
Yeah, please tell us. Thanks.
Yeah. Anyway, back to the match. Now. Kendeep scores another crush counter, does not convert, but he still has the advantage. Now I must remind you that when you hit a crush counter, you will build a little bit of V-trigger gauge too.
Yes.
So that's why they're very important, even more so than what would be obvious. Okay, goes for the dash in into the meaty. And Twinsist again with the V-trigger, scores a hit, does not convert, but gets out of corner and puts Candy in the corner.
I realized one thing about Winter. Like, I think every single time he used the wet trigger, it was the same side where he started. He didn't cross up.
In front of the opponent.
Yeah.
But usually Candy was pressing buttons, so it was very good for Winter.
Yeah, but most of the dashes are going behind you.
Yes.
But he's not. Even if he's in the corner, he stays in the corner.
Yep. But of course, if you hit, that doesn't matter too much.
Of course.
Oh, and just like that, neutral jump and resets into 8th row. Very nice from Candy.
Round 2.
He's on the match point right now.
Yes, he is. Ay, bonita. Let's go in, and he scores another hit in the command grab. Now, there's the knockdown. What's he then gonna do? He goes for the meaty, jumps in, but Winces is ready with the anti-air. And now he backdashes to safety, does not decide to anti-air again. And crouching medium, very good. A very good move from Nash. Advantages on block as usual, medium punches out.
Again, the same side.
And yes, the same side. This time Candy was ready with the block. Okay, gets hit by the meaty and launches to the other end again. We have a stun. Winces is in the zone, but that does not. But it's not going to kill. He needs another one, another hit.
Yeah, he saved his meter, but
he
first need to win this round.
Oh my, just like that. If Candy lands a super, this is gonna be it, but the neutral jump saves Winces right here. Now we know it was a good decision to save this meter.
Fight.
Now we can say that Winces has good decision-making skills.
But now both have a full bar.
Yes, they're sitting on full meter. And Candy, he used super before, so we'll see if he goes for it in this match. Because right now Candy is sitting on match point. Oh, gets the crash counter. Into the knockdown. Into the meaty, but Winces teleports out to safety. Oh, but Candy is still in it. Nice air-to-air, but gets thrown away. And just like that, Candy is sitting down, very patient, very slow.
He has 60 seconds.
Yes, and a lot of life advantage, but Winces is ready with the throw and the anti-air. That's very important to anti-air in this game. He tried neutral jumping, but did not get the hit, gets the cross-up, this is gonna be big.
This will not kill, but it will be quite close. But he gets the Nash health at the same time.
Yes, but he will only be killed by a super if he blocks.
Yes.
And now, since Laura's super is a throw, she cannot use it safely to cheat.
Yeah.
Oh, but he gets hit by the standing jab.
Okay, so that means Candy advances.
Yes.
And unfortunately,
that ends.
Winces is
out of the tournament.
Yes.
So how are we with the sound quality?
I will check.
Yep.
Immediately after updating the bracket.
Yes, of course.
Okay. No. The Stream Monsters didn't answer at all.
Oh, come on, Stream Monster.
Sounds good, guys. Okay.
Thank you, based Hooded Plover. That's very nice of you. Okay,
it
so.
Seems we are taking a little pause.
No,
for
I,
some reason.
I don't think so. Candy Deep is in there,
yeah,
right?
They are on the yeah. stage, but the organizers were saying something.
Oh, yes, they were asking Candy Deep whether or not he wants to have a short break.
Oh, it was a question.
Yeah, but he's good.
That's good.
I mean, it's very hard when you're playing a tournament and you have to play your matches back to back. Sometimes it's really good to just take a breath,
yes.
slow down a bit.
Definitely.
And? And right now we're having two of very interesting players right now. We have Candy, who plays Laura, of course. And now, Laura, very explosive character, good reset potential, rushdown oriented. And Kejim. Kejim is playing Mika, as we already saw him do. Mika, of course, is a kind of offensive monster, I would say. She's big, she's burly, and she's gonna break you if she gets you into the corner.
But she's Glass Cannon, and that's good for Laura.
Oh, yes.
But Laura's reach is about the same as Mika's, and that's good
okay.
for Mika.
Yes, that's right. So, the thing is, Laura does not have strong anti-air moves normals. She has a very good anti-air special. So, that's what Candy should rely on the most, although it's harder to hit with it. Because
yes.
you have to be ready much more than for just pressing one button.
Yes.
And in the meantime, Kejim is not one to jump recklessly. That's important. He's very patient.
It will be interesting because
yep.
this match can end with insane, super fast exchanges
yes.
of
yes.
blows.
Yes, yes, yes.
Or in long, patient waiting and spacing.
Mm-hmm.
We will see.
Mm-hmm.
Probably it will be something in between, but it will be very easy.
That's right.
To slip one way or other.
That's
to
right.
the extreme.
That's right. See, but as you said before, Laura and Mika's best ranges are the same. They overlap.
Exactly.
So the thing is, even if Laura scores a hit, she's in command grab range.
Yeah.
And it's the same for Mika.
That means that, but that means like Mika have vortex, Laura have explosive damage.
Yes, that's right. So, see, for example, if
Alex, okay.
So Candy Deep is going with Alex, that's interesting.
Alex.
See, this Rainbow changes Mika. The matchup a lot. Because while Alex, yeah, Kejim is playing Mika, so he'll be on player one side. And now, see, Alex with the 90s outfit.
Baywatch.
Round
yes.
one.
Fight. And like the color.
California boy.
Like, Alex is... Well, he's not tanky. His throws are not so far reaching, but
yep.
still his throws reach farther than Mika's.
Only
and
slightly, but yeah.
as well.
See, that's the point. Alex is a better pick for Mika because he can just stick out his long reaching normals like Das Boot.
Exactly.
Right here you saw Das Boot. Very strong standing roundhouse. And Candy is on point with the throw tech game. On point with the jump outs. Very good. Very good from Candy. He's ready for the command grabs. Oh, and Kejim. Here comes Kejim with the crush counter.
Also, one thing to be afraid of.
Yep.
If the trigger and start parrying and you parry the flat,
yep.
if Mika continues, she will still grab you because it's considered to be a grab.
Yes.
So no matter that you parry the attack,
yep.
you will and be catched, only you will take zero damage. But she
oh,
will
really?
Get the frame, yes.
Okay.
But she will get the frame advantage.
So you get combo.
So because you will be stumbling across the,
yep.
across the
yep. And now, Kejim going
nice.
For the throw and setting up the dropkick, but Candy is on point. Hitting Kejim out of his dropkick.
So important thing against Mika. Can't be better.
Yes,
nice.
Now we have very strong cross counter combo into the V-skill setup. Now, this is very nice to see the combo actually in match because the thing is that after Alex stuns you, he can use V-skill to guarantee another crash counter,
yes.
sort of.
No, it's not sort of. It's. Yes, on the screen you have different...
Yeah, it works the same, but it's called differently.
It's called different, but it does completely the same damage,
yes.
result, everything is the same.
Yes. But now here comes Kejim, into the throw, into the entire anticipation and Dr. Stunta. Okay, now Ketchin is really in the zone, he's going for the setup, changing sides, and that's
it. That was quite risky, he should go for the critical art. From the stun, he can easily convert to critical art.
That's true.
The easiest way, do the mic, drop the mic, do the critical art to even increase the damage. It's stylish, and it
but
will...
You know,
because like this, he needed the reset and one more guess to ensure the victory.
But see, I think that Ketchin was all about being in the zone. So he was continuing with the mix-ups and the resets, because that's what he was thinking about. And again, the throw, and another throw. Ketchin is in there, with the medium punch, with the jabs. Okay, tries the body drop, but can't even is on point with this anti-air. Oh, gets Irish Whip into the mid-screen, and Ketchin continues for full damage, tries the clap, goes for the jump in, but switches sides, he puts himself in the corner, gets the crash counter. This is very big now, Ketchin. Oh, can't deep ready for the throw with the tech. And just trying to ease his way in. But here comes Ketchin. Okay, so we have one match. Yeah, one match for Ketchin. Oh no, he's not smiling, he's just doing the Ketchin.
Okay.
That's his resting Ketchin face.
Okay,
gets the sweep. No crash counter this time, but gets the command grab nonetheless. And now we have jabs. Oh, and jumping short. Great. And gets the crash counter. Now he's ready for the Irish whip. Yeah. To the corner you go. Oh! And we go for the super. This animation is amazing. I gotta say, this bomb is what I want to see more of in Street Fighter V. But here comes Ketchin, he's still in there. Goes for the Nadeshiko mix-up, does not get it, but he's still on the offense. Oh, Candy tried to go for the command grab, this would have sealed the deal, but instead it's Ketchin who wins.
By the way, do you know that Alex have true unblockable?
True unblockables? How come?
Yes, setup.
Okay.
If he crash counter you with his sweep.
Okay.
It's a hard knockdown.
Yes.
You have set frames.
Yeah.
If he cancel the sweep, which is
V-trigger,
V-trigger, with one punch, light punch, and then full charge.
Okay.
The crashing shoulder.
Yes. The focus attack.
You will stand up exactly in the moment when it will hit you.
Oh, I did
so
not know that.
It's not much damage, but it guarantees it, and it guarantees the stun that you get out of the hit.
Yep.
And if you have the X bar for the double throw, it's a lot of the stun.
Yes.
So, to some extent, this is extremely dirty setup.
Yep.
In the right situation, this changes the match completely.
I see. So, now Kendeep going back. I don't think he should switch to Laura, but...
Well, he loses two games in a row with Alex without winning single round. All
the
rounds were somehow close, but he didn't get a single of them.
Yep.
So, probably he feels it shouldn't be worse if he changed to Laura.
Yep. And, you know, if you want to go out, it's better to go out with the Bonita.
Yes.
Round one.
Okay, right now, here we go. Kanzuki Estate. Very nice stage, I like it. But here comes Ketchin and Ken Deep goes with the throw. Does not get much of a Oki afterwards. And now Ketchin with the jumping short into the throw. Clap. Does not convert. Open the match.
You know this fat kick in the red?
It's
from the train floor. He was under the bridge.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, I remember that. But in the meantime, we have Ketchin going for the full combo.
Going crazy, but he dropped the combo.
He drops it.
No punish. And
this is bad.
And no punish.
Yeah, Ketchin with the Irish whip. I mean, got Irish whip blocked, but Candy was not ready for the punish.
Round two.
Oh, now just one round more. Ketchin on match point. And on his way to loser's finals.
Nerf Mika. Capcom Nerf Mika.
Don't nerf, buff, or patch, or adapt. It's up to you, man, but I'm not gonna...
I really like Mika. I like her, how she is.
I'm not gonna ask Captain to fix the game for me. I'd rather get good.
Yeah.
Oh, and again, see, that's the thing. After the blocked elbow dash, Laura is minus, so she's susceptible to throws. And Ketchum is aware of that. Now, Irish Whip, that's it. Ketchum goes forward. Ketchum and Hayat. So this is winner's finals.
Losers finals.
This is losers finals. Thanks for being on point with the brackets game, Unicorn. Ketchum.
Come on.
Ketchum.
Mistakes were made. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, mistakes keep being made. I'm sorry, this was an extremely long weekend.
Oh, yes. But you've successfully pulled it off, and now here we are, the losers finals, and winner advances to fight Chinu. Now see, this is going to be a real match right here, because the thing is, Hayat can be very defensive, you know. He can really create.
All matches are real on this journey.
But you know, the thing is about Hayat as a player, he can really just sit back and create this wall of China in front of him with the standing fierce, yes. With Kikokens, you know. Whereas Ketchum, he's very patient, but he cannot play patiently with Mika. Okay, so we're gonna do a short 2-minute break for Ketchum. I'm gonna use the time and go for a short minute break too.
Okay.
So I'll be right back, please wait.
So, let me update the stream. Okay, and we'll be back in 2 minutes. Okay, and it's coming. Oh, another typo of me. I'm sorry, the keyboard is really... horrible.
Here I am. Better. Rock you like a hurricane.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello.
How's it going? I've been missing you all.
Let's take a look if they... No one miss us.
That's too bad. But see...
Our boys in finals, but not finals we wanted. Oh, come on.
Well, everybody's entitled to the finals they want. It's just that they're gonna get... Well, they're gonna get what they're gonna get.
Yeah.
And right now we're getting Kejim and Hayat in the losers finals. This is going to be hype.
Yeah, and I hope that Mika will win. Because I hate Chun-Li.
Okay, that's a reason.
Mika is cool. Actually,
I'm gonna be a little bit biased and I'm gonna say that Hayat is gonna take it.
And
hopefully it's gonna be commentator's curse. Because Kejim, well, see, the thing is, Hayat, if he keeps being on point, he can keep Kejim out for as long as it takes. Especially with Chun-Li's normals.
Exactly.
They're very strong. And even more so against Mika. But of course, we already know that if Kejim gets in, he can just run a train on you. Oh, and just like that, standing fist. This is going to be very important in this matchup. Okay, look at Hayat, he's slowly backing himself into the corner, but every time he throws something out, it usually hits.
And mainly, like, he's backing himself in the corner, but take a look, without taking out much of the life, he reset it twice, back to the middle of the stage, from the corner.
Yes, and just like that, Kejim is already down almost 2/3 of his life. Gets the throw, but no follow-up.
High
up with the wake-up jab. And instant air legs. Now he's going in a little bit. He doesn't have to, but right now he has a lot of advantage. And that's how he gets
with
the first round.
Easier round two. To kill Mika than to give her a chance to get in.
Yep.
And start.
Okay, and catching with jumping roundhouse. Then the body splash, and we have a throw. Now Hayat is in the corner. But Kejim is respecting him, you can see it. He's not going in crazy. Okay, goes for the body splash again.
Cannot ignore Chun-Li's damage. He hit you with the combo.
Yes.
And as Mika, you block him.
Yes, that's true.
And you need to respect that.
And the throw again. Now, Kejim is playing a little bit better. Faring a little bit better against Hayat. Goes for the full combo. Irish whips him into the resets. Oh, and gets the reset. So we have
it. Like Mika get one opening and successfully
Yes. So it's a one round all, and so far zero wins in the matches. Now both characters sitting at full meter. This is big.
It's -5. It's punishable. You need to punish it.
Yes.
Mika's cool.
Oh, it's very nice.
Oh.
Catching runs under the instant air leg, but unfortunately drops the follow-up. Okay, now it's high up. Goes for the chin. That is weird. It's not gonna kill, and it's not gonna stun.
He was ready to pull it out in case of it.
Yes.
But he missed the confirm and just pulled it out.
Yep. Oh, saves himself with the B reversal. Catching dashes into the command grab, but doesn't get the hit. And here comes Hayat. Oh, here comes Kejim with the throw. Now Hayat. Oh, but he's on point with the anti-airs. I was just going to say that Hayat is in range of Mika killing combos.
But yet, Mika is one of the few characters in the game where you are not entitled to say it's over until she's dead.
Oh, yes.
Her comeback potential is insane.
That's true. And we get a counter hit body splash. And the command grab puts him into the corner. Stay there. That's right. You stay there. And you're gonna get another Irish whip. Go back to the corner.
Oh, whip.
He whipped. Oh my. And he whipped the command grab. Follow up. That's a big draw from Kejim. And now Hayat has him against the corner. He's going in with the combos, with the spinning bird kick knockdowns.
That whip throw was really unfortunate.
Yes.
Because he tried to control the low punch to ensure there will be a jump or something.
Yep.
But the low punch hit as counter hit.
Yes.
And because of that, you know, you cannot throw someone who's in,
yes,
in animation.
In the
and the counter hit animation is 2 frames longer than the standard,
yes,
animation.
Yes, that's
and because
right.
of that, the throw is.
Yep. But still, Kejin managed to turn the tide and won the first round of the second match. Now, Hayat has one match so far, but this is first to three, so a lot will still happen. Okay, now Kejin slowly easing in, blocking the Kikokens. Okay, slides under it, just outside of Hayat's range. Oh, that was interesting. He was, I believe he was expecting EX reversal quickly, but that wasn't the best. Yes.
But as you guys, you have a very good counter in it. Just jump up and go down with the heavy kick.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, catch him still in there, but gets anti-air and EX and air lightning legs. See, that's how it goes, back and forth. The first round was very convincing for Kejin until Hayat started reversing. Now, the second round is pretty convincing for Hayat, but Kejin can still reverse. Now Hayat confirming into the stun, so close, but not quite get it. Oh, and instant overhead. No, not enough meter. Oh, and he gets the kill. Okay, now Kejin is a little bit phased. I'm guessing he does understand the situation he's in. If he loses this one, he's going home. Not without a trophy, I might add.
He will answer.
But
what he will miss is the frostbite. But he will still get jump.
Yep. And the glass.
A little smaller one.
Yep.
And he will get it.
Unless he manages to ease in on Hayat, get in and start some real Mika offense just like that. He goes under, starts a combo, does not get the reset. Is he being nervous right now? I can't really tell. So far he's had a few big drops.
He's not smiling. He's not smiling. This is the first time I see him not smiling.
Yeah, he's not doing the catch him anymore. This is serious. Okay, gets the splash, but Hayat confirms into the killing combo. Watch all of it, pay attention. And now we're moving to match point Hayat. Catching so far very much down on wins. Hayat has big advantage. And so far Catching has made a few big mistakes. Oh, but gets the throw. What's gonna be? Oh, should have gone for the meaty, unfortunately. Hayat is not the one to shy away from wake-up jabs. He knows it works. Okay, and another knockdown.
Kejin's meetings are usually avoid on instant wake-up, but
yep.
Delay wake-up,
yep.
He knows the dumpster is missing there.
Okay, both jumping away. Now this is weird. Why would Kejin jump away right now? Oh, and that's it. Hayat takes game 3. Kejin still waiting for the sequence to finish, and that's it. Now it's time to stand up.
Chun-Li win.
And finally, we have
finals.
That's right. So the next match is going to be Hayat against Chino.
This is replay of the match we already saw.
Yes.
Back there, Chino won.
Yes. But you know, it's not uncommon in the tournaments for one player to be knocked down to the loser's bracket and then come all the way up to challenge the one person who knocked him down and win. Because you have a lot of time to think about the matchup.
Did happen in the finals of the 20 years anniversary.
Yes.
Where Daigo lost to
Infiltration.
Infiltration, right. After beating him like 3-0 to the
yes.
Retros,
yes.
He lost 6-0 without getting a single round.
Yes, that's right.
I'm not completely sure, but I think with like 2 perfects in the process. That was insane comeback.
Yes, that's right. But of course that was a long time ago and time has changed a bit. Okay. So, the players are now both ready.
They're doing the button check.
Yes. They're doing a little bit of button check. Yeah, we're doing the serious button check.
Oh, it's nice meeting you, man. Take care.
Sure.
Thanks for coming, man, and thanks for commentating. Thanks for commentating.
We're still waiting for the players to finish. This is a very serious button check, I would say. Take care. Yes, by now some players are leaving. It is Sunday after all, and we all have to get home.
Yeah. Some of us already have angry calls from their wives.
I would assume so. Yeah, I'm waiting for my 9 p.m. 10 hours trip back to Warsaw. Oh. But I think after 3 days of button check, I'll be ready to sleep. Finally get some rest.
Time over.
Oh, we're having some frame drops.
Round two. Fight.
What happened? Chino. Yeah. Okay, so Chino is from Sweden.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
No, it's not.
Okay, so yes,
button check is
now
finished.
The players are ready.
But I mean in the game, not the tourney. The tourney is almost finished. This is the the last grand finals.
Yes, that is right.
And after that, it will be it. There will be the final celebration for Guilty Gear and Street Fighter.
Yes,
that I works. Will do my best to stream it at least somehow.
Yep.
Using the same camera.
Yep.
And after that, it will be it.
Okay. So, now we're going in. This is it, my friends. This is Button Check Street Fighter V Grand Finals. Chino from Sweden against Hayat from Kuwait. Let's go.
Sorry.
Of course, Hayat sporting the battle costume. Chino the default one.
Fight.
And now they're going in. So far, slowly trying to get some space, feel each other out. And Chino gets the early knockdown. So, Hayat on point with his footsies, with the frame drops, taking some chunks of life away from Chino with the standing fierce mostly. Oh, and the shorts, the crouching shorts, they do the job well. And again, with the standing fierce. But Chino is ready with the roundhouse. Hayat going in with the lightning leg. Chino ready with the DP, but Chino is still sitting on almost stunned. Now he's safe.
Oh,
and that was a trade. But Chino with the crouching forward into the drill, the classic strategy, the basic combo for Kami. That takes him round one. Now, I must remind you that Chino only has to win 3 matches, whereas Hayat has to win 6. And he's almost at the stun. That's it, that's the stun. Chino, very strong follow-up combo.
Oh, he didn't follow up.
Yeah, that was weird, but
he gets the mid-roll during the combo, so maybe
he
was not ready to take any risk.
Sure, that makes sense. So that's first match for Chino. I'm wondering about Hayat. He's capable, and for sure he can adapt. But Chino is a strong opponent. So far he's proven that he's a challenge to everyone else. And he might not let Hayat adapt. He might just stay out of his ability.
And don't forget that Chino definitely, Amy definitely have tools to went around Chino's defense.
Yeah.
Like, he's not like exactly in Kami's favor, but actually it's quite equal. And that's something given the fact that Shun is considered top tier in this game.
Yes. Yeah, that's right. And again, with the dive kick, if it burns meter, doesn't get the hit, this is the inconvenience for Chino. Oh, and this is gonna be big. Yes, Hayat confirms, converts into spinning bird kick, chases him down. Oh, and he whips the V-trigger drill. Now Hayat jumping out, and again, just baiting Chino to do something. And Chino was chasing him down, desperately trying to land a hit. That's what doomed him. But that's only one round. We still have ways to go. Oh, and the bait with the EX drill. Oh, but again, Hayat was ready for the DP and converts. Huge damage, one third of his life down, but gets the DP going. Yes. Hayat still has critical art, full V trigger, but so does Chino. Now he's gonna go for the critical art, but only if he succeeds in hitting again. Oh man, the stick! And that's how Hayat takes game one, with the Air Lightning Legs. Now, Air Lightning Legs, new addition to Chun-Li's arsenal. Of course, she could do them in, for example, Marvel vs. Capcom 3, but that was a bit of a different game, I might add. So,
will we see any characters?
I wouldn't assume so. I don't know about Chino, but I don't think Hayat would change. I mean, one thing, Chun-Li is perfectly capable of fighting anyone. Okay, and again, double fierce. This damage is real. And again, with the fierce, now Chino ready to block counters. And goes on the offensive. Yes, Hayat burns meter, but does not get much of a break. Yes, almost. Almost. He whiffs the DP and still gets hit. Hayat perfectly converts into as much damage as he could. Jumps in, does not get punished, and the crouching shorts. Yep. Okay, and again, a bit of a mid-range game. Now Chino tried to dash in, but Hayat stopped him in his tracks with the crouching forward. Now standing fierce, crouching forward into the Kikoken. Chino tried the V-skill. And again, with the dive kick, but Hayat was ready. Burning meter for the EX. And again, he baits the DP. That's the third DP Hayat baited and punished properly.
And in the meantime, he didn't kill a single one.
Yes.
He successfully baited three DP.
Yes. Oh, yes. And again, with the fiercest. Man, he scores so much damage on those footsies. Oh, this time, the risk was not worth it. Chino on point with the combo game, but hit thrown, and that's it. Second match to Hayat, we may have a reset. Now I will remind you that this is a reset point for Hayat. If he wins the next match, or another one, he will reset the bracket, and then we're gonna have a go at the real Grand Finals.
And so far, Chick, he didn't have a single reset always. The person coming from the winner's side won the final.
Yes. Oh, and again! Again with the bait DP and the punish already halfway down the surround. Chino lost so much health, but he's recovering from the stun. Hayat uses V-skill to escape the corner, but Chino is ready. Now again, Hayat burns meter.
Fine.
And finally. Yes, Chino needed that hit to regain confidence in his DPs, because so far they weren't working out. Gets the hit with his own standing fierce, and Hayat counters with the anti-air. Goes for the throw, now there's big distance between both players, but Chino does not have the trigger to go.
Wow.
And again, crouching shorts.
And reset point.
Yes, reset point for Hayat, just the next round is enough. Oh my god, he makes Chino with the DP, does not punish in time, but still this is big. And Chino putting Hayat into the corner, crosses up with the V-skill. Hayat ready, air to air, into the lightning legs. Goes for throw, and Chino ready, activates V-trigger, but he does the dive kick. That costs him half of his V-trigger gauge. Gets the throw nonetheless. And Hayat activates with the V-trigger of his own. Now Chino converts into Super Blitz, not gonna kill. overhead, still can block some hits, and he converts into a super OP zone. This should be enough. This should be enough. And this is the reset. Here we go.
Not all players was sure if it was kill or not. Both
yes.
were still with the hands.
Yes.
And carefully watching how in the air.
Yes. Because.
So we got reset.
Yeah, this round might one. Have ended in the magic pixel range.
Right. Yeah.
But as I said, it did not kill. It did not. So we have the reset, the real grand finals.
Three reset games, except the very first one, was very convincing by Haya.
Yeah.
But let's see if Chino may have a mindset of yes, this is just a testing ground.
Yeah.
I will win, I will win. If I will lose, I will really have it and so on.
Yes.
I
yes.
will condition it.
Well, it doesn't look like conditioning worked very well in his favor. Because once again, you should see that although the dive kicks from Kami seem to be really easy to beat, Hayat goes for the DX reversal every time. And yes, that's big damage from Chinook, but here comes Hayat with the confirm. That was a sure kill. Very easy, very simple, but yet so effective. And now Hayat going in with the jump in, crouching jabs, go for the Kikoken. And now we're having crouching, now we have Fierce. Oh, and again, Chinu just away from the character. I'm expecting that he wanted to catch, I suppose he wanted to catch the opponent off guard with the dive kick. But again, it did not work out. Although here comes Chinu with the V-trigger cancel. Not get the full damage, wanted to go for the reset, and it may cost him yet. Now Chun-Li, of course, with her V-trigger very long, does not defeat easily. And I'm going for the confirm. Oh, but Chinu does not get the follow-up, both characters have super. Now any hit will seal the deal. And this one goes to Hayat.
Chun-Li wins.
An interesting change. I mean, this proves that Chino did not adapt in time. He decides to switch characters, goes for Nash. Now,
round one.
I can't say how much of a difference matchup-wise this makes, but I would say
it's definitely able to challenge Chun-Li, but
yes.
in a completely different way.
Yes, game. Yes, exactly. And see, the thing is. Hayat used to play Nash, so he's very familiar with Nash's options. Yes. Hayat used to play M. Bison, then he switched to Nash only for a bit, but he spent a few days playing Nash, getting to know the character, and only then he transitioned into Chun-Li.
Okay.
Oh, but gets... Oh! Gets the crash counter, but not the follow-up. It's very bad for Chino. See, he still has 3 games to go, whereas Hayat is sitting on 1 victory after the reset. Gets hit, converts into knockdown. Oh, but the bazooka knee doesn't.
Round 2. Quite.
But this looks like quite a different match.
Oh, yes, yes.
We saw last few games.
Now, see, the thing with the change is that although it's sort of slightly uncomfortable for Chino, because he has to change his mentality, it also forces a change in Hayat's game plan.
Yeah. Chino will use all the information he collected
yes.
in the previous matches.
Yes.
Why Hayat cannot be sure about anything, because this is different character.
Yes.
Different.
Yes, that's true.
And this
yes. But right now Hayat was ready for the V-trigger from Chino, got him out of the air, and continues the pressure with the instant air lightning legs. And now Chino on board with the air-to-air, but Hayat counters with the EX reversal, and that is it. Now we have one round for Chino and one round for Hayat.
fight!
Yes. So he goes with the moonsault, but doesn't get the follow up and catches Hayat's Swiss kill. Now Hayat again on point with the anti-airs, gets the hit, goes for the throw, but Chinu is ready with the tech. Throws Hayat into the corner and jumps in, jumping around. How this is big, a lot of damage. And the moonsault is advantages on block, but Hayat counters with a V reversal. Now, of course, this means that Hayat will not get a V trigger in this round, almost for sure. So he's very much down on life. And not like that. Chinu catches him with the anti-air EX moonsault.
Nash wins. Round one. Fight.
Now. Exactly. Now this is very nice awareness from Hayat. He does the neutral jump, but then counters into lightning legs to be sure that he moves out of the danger zone. Okay, and again, his V skill is countered, this time by moving hold. Hayat going in with the Fierce. And then the wall jump. Gets the hit with crouching Fierce and a few back medium punches. And then the free skill goes over the fireball right in the face of Chinu. But Chinu counters with an offense of his own. Now both ready for the throw. A bit of fireball wars. Now see, that's the thing with fireball wars. You can do it with both characters, but you're not gonna get anything off of that. You have to transition. Yeah, but you have to transition to something else. And both characters are sitting on full bar.
Now, yeah, back then, both were probably looking for the critical bar because both were pretty close. So get in there.
Yes. And right now, anything kills, and this is big. Yeah, the whip was real, so Hayat just confirmed into a little kill. Oh. Okay. So we have the Fierce going on from Chinu, jumping around house, very strong normal. And now a bit of Kikoken Wars. Nice, Chinu read that properly. Oh, but he gets hit for his trouble with the V-skill. The V-skill combo so real, but now we have anti-air moonsault. And the confirm again off of jumping. Yes, now Chinu is in the corner, but manages to put Hayat in his place. Okay, backs away. Chinu now a bit patient. Now they're both down on life, but they both are super, so nobody wants to take too many risks. Oh, and that should have been it. He could have cancelled into the super. And now Hayat is almost gonna let it go. Chinu was ready with the punish, but doesn't get the combo, but gets the overhead.
Final round. Fight.
Okay, and now Chinu opening with the side. Usual opening for Nash, although Chinu did not do it. Okay, gets the hit. All from the X side. Doesn't get the full damage, but still knocks Hayat out of the air. Okay, a few tokens and very strong heavy kick. Short block string from Chinu. He goes for the bazooka knee, but gets hit out of his pressure. And now a punish. Now I don't know about that. I mean, damage is damage, but he knocked Hayat so far away from him.
I think he just went for sheer damage.
Yes. And Hayat converts into EX legs. Chinu waking up with super and Hayat ready for the punish. That's gonna be it. Hayat 2 wins, Chinu only 1. So here we go. This is tournament point for Hayat. Grand finals, boys.
Round 1. Fight.
And the grand final, the boy stuck with standing roundhouse, gets hit by the side. but quickly converts. His pressure is so on point with the jumping instant air lightning leg. Jin gets hit twice. Once, Hayat does not convert, but the second time, goes for full damage. Now Jin with the bazooka gets punished. This is minus 4 at worst. So easy punish for Chun-Li. And keeps Chino on the defense. Now Chino managed to get some air-to-air roundhouse. Good damage, but it's not gonna change the match. Now he converts into the V-trigger teleport. Full combo, but here comes Haya. Okay, with short pressure of his own, backs away, just backs right in. Goes for long short. And cross up short. I mean cross under, actually. So Chino crossed himself up with the jump.
And that's a quick tournament point.
Yes. That is it.
Haya.
Now Chino with the throw. And another throw. Will he gonna get the third one? Haya ready with the V reversal. And the instant air legs. They do so much damage when he hit twice or thrice in a row. Now we have a trade. The grand finalist and the champion of Button Check Spring 2016 edition Street Fighter V tournament. Let's hear it for Hayat.
And for now, I will
start. Hayat with the jump in after the V skill. Okay, Chino very low on life, gets the meter. Hayat on two bars, gets the hit, and it's gonna be instant overhead that's taking the tournament. Okay, so this is it. Hayat from Kuwait taking his tournament. He is the winner, the grand finalist, and the champion of Button Check Spring 2016 edition Street Fighter V tournament. Let's hear it for Hayat.
And for now, I will.